And now onto the dinosaur of the day, Paralititan, which was a request from Dinosaur4602 via YouTube, so thanks. It was a titanosaur that lived in the Cretaceous in what is now Egypt in the Bahariya Formation, and the name means tidal giant. The type species is Paralititan stromeri, and the full name means Stromer's tidal giant. The name honors Ernst Stromer von Reichenbach, the German paleontologist who found dinosaurs in the Bahariya Oasis in Egypt in the early 1900s. And it was named by Joshua Smith, Matthew Lamanna, Kenneth Lacovara, Peter Dodson, Jennifer Smith, Jason Poole, Robert Gigengack, and Yousri Attia in 2001. Paralititan was the first tetrapod reported from the area since 1935. Researchers found only partial postcranial remains, not the skull, and this included vertebrae, a pectoral girdle, and forelimb elements. The specimen that they found was probably scavenged. Paralititan may have been prey for Bahariasaurus, Carcharodontosaurus, and possibly Spinosaurus, but only if they hunted in groups. Also, Spinosaurus may not have been able to hunt on land. The Paralititan skeleton found was preserved in tidal flat deposits with fossilized mangroves. It was a tidal ecosystem and tropical. Paralititan is one of the largest dinosaurs. It's up there with Dreadnoughtus, Tyrannosaurus, Argentinosaurus, so that's why if it was prey, it would have had to be taken down by a group.
And now Patagotitan.
Yes. Good call. One science journalist said in 2001 that Paralititan, quote, appears to have been the second largest known creature to ever walk on Earth, end quote. But remember, that was back in 2001, and we've since found
Patagotitan.
Yes.
And it's really hard to rank them, as we've said before, so kind of hard to say.
But it has a 5.5 foot or 1.7 meter long humerus. Not much is known about Paralititan, but it's thought to have weighed about 59 tons or 65 short tons and maybe was 85 feet or 26 meters long. It may have had osteoderms used for defense. So the land where Paralititan lived was sometimes underwater for long periods of time when global sea levels rose and then reappeared when sea levels dropped again. And Paralititan helps show that Africa and South America may have been part of the same landmass in the late Cretaceous. Groups of animals have been found common to both South America and Madagascar from the time, but not so much from Africa, possibly because there's not been much research done over there. Paralititan also lived around the same time and place as Egyptosaurus, which was another sauropod.